Seizures come from a group of neurons in the brain misfiring. And what causes those neurons to misfire can be a lot of different things. The brain is designed to keep all the bad things out. So when something creeps in, whether it's blood from a hemorrhagic stroke or toxins from something that is not safe for the brain, those things automatically put the brain at risk for seizures. A seizure can also be caused by a brain tumor, and it's one of the most common reasons why people present into our ER when they are found to have a brain tumor. So the question, why do brain tumors cause seizures, is something that as a group of academic epileptologists, neuro-oncologists, neurosurgeons, we are really trying to better understand. If we think about a tumor as sort of a structural ball, that does not provoke seizures itself. It's something about this environment sitting within normal brain tissue that is provoked to misfire. We used to think that it was primarily just a mechanical process, just you're pushing on the brain gets mad, misfires. But now we understand the genetic makeup of that. That's rendering that outside environment up from the tumor to be ready to misfire because of the electrical imbalance. So a question that is often asked, especially for patients who are coming in with a seizure and then they undergo resection or surgery, is do I have to worry about seizures anymore? And not all patients will become seizure-free from a surgery. And it also depends on the ongoing medical treatment, the oncologic treatments, and seizure medications that we're using. So our goal is to render a patient seizure-free through the collaboration between the surgeon in planning the surgery, along with myself from the epilepsy side and thinking about it from a seizure side, and the oncologist about the tumor types and how else can we best maximize this resection. So all of us are working together to really make sure that the day-to-day life that this patient walks away with is the best it possibly could.